Skinny Wayne Shepherd Band.
Of my second album called Trouble Is. And yeah, thank you. 25 years of anything is a great thing, I gotta say. But we started this tour last year in the US and we recorded a new version of the Trouble Is album. And we launched this tour in my hometown in Shreveport, Louisiana. And, you know, we thought it might be, you know, a tour we do for a couple of two or three months maybe. But the fans just kept asking us to bring it to more places, different cities, different states across the US, and it kept getting extended and the shows were selling out everywhere. And then I started looking at, you know, it's been a while since we've been over here and we were finally going to come back. And I thought, this tour has just been going so well for us over there, we might as well bring it over here for you guys as well. So here we are tonight. Many of you were probably looking for us to come back a little sooner. We're sorry that it took so long, but we're really glad to be here. And so this evening is gonna be a great show. I've been looking forward to bringing it to you guys. And the way that it's gonna work is that this is the very first time ever that we've played an entire album live in concert. Even when this album was brand new, we never played the whole record live in concert. So what we're doing is we're playing every song off the record in a slightly different order because it makes for a better live concert. And some of the songs will be extended versions and some of them will be very much like what you've heard on the record. But as soon as we're finished playing all of those songs, we're gonna walk off the stage and we are going to pretend like we're not coming back. But if you clap loud enough and stomp your feet and all those, you know, amazing things that show that you've been having a good time, we're certainly gonna come back, right? There's nowhere for us to go anyway. So. And when we do, I have a whole other set of music that we prepared for you guys, a collection of songs that appear on various records that we put out in the 25 years since Trouble Is came out, because we've been making new music this whole time. And as a matter of fact, we have a new record that we've just put the finishing touches on and we're hoping to get it out later this year. So I want you to all be on the lookout for that, because you know what that means. A new record means a new tour, and a new tour means we get to come back and play for you guys again, right? So anyways, I'm gonna keep the show moving along this next song. I do give a brief introduction. It's a song that taught me a really amazing lesson about, you know, how my music might affect people's lives or the role that it might play in their lives. I've always been a sucker for love songs. I had a title rolling around in my head, I Found Love When I Found You, and I wrote it with my friend Danny Tate. And we put it on this record, and ever since we released this album, I get messages from someone every week that's coming to the show, and they say, please play that song because that was our wedding song. And I had no idea, you know, I was 18 years old when I wrote these songs. I had no idea that just by being inspired to write that song and through the music that we recorded, that I could actually be present in people's lifelong memories in a moment that they'll never forget. And that was a pretty profound realization for me. So every night there's usually someone in the audience that got married to the song. And if it was your wedding song, or even if you're looking for a wedding song, I'd recommend this one. And we're gonna send this out to you. It's called I Found Love When I Found You.
I found you. I found you. Oh, spend your time away like this. Existing.
Singles off this album, and all of them charted in the top 10 on the rock charts, most of them between number 5 and number 1, but this one, we released it and it took off and went straight up to number 1 on the rock charts, and it stayed there for so long that at the time it set a record for the most consecutive weeks at number 1 in the history of the rock charts in the U.S. And we reached a lot of people with this song and still continue to do so today. People are still discovering this song, and 20 years after we released it, some friends of mine from a band called Five Finger Death Punch called me, and then they said they were going to cover it for their latest album. I think it came out in 2019, so it was right around 20 years after we put it out, and then they put it out. We did a collaboration. It was them, and I played guitar on it. We had Brian May from Queen come and play guitar on it, and Brantley Gilbert, so we had like classic rock and heavy rock and blues and country all come together and did a new version of that song, and the Five Finger Death Punch guys released it and went up to number 1 on the rock charts all over again 20 years later. But the most amazing thing about the song to me, though, is that is the stories that people have shared with me about their personal lives as relates to this song. And everybody's story is different because we're all unique, you know, but there's a common thread in all of their stories. And every person that's written to me about this, they were going through a really difficult time in their life. And somehow they said, listening to this song, it helped them to feel understood, and it also helped them to get to the other side just a little bit faster. And to me, that makes it all worth it. You know, the idea that I could write a song that might help somebody is just the most incredible thing to me. And I'm very grateful to you. I've been a part of writing this song. So anyways, if you guys know the words, feel free to sing along with us on this one, okay?
Thank you.
to where it all began.
Train, Bryant. been on lead vocals for the past 25 years since we did Trouble Is. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the one and only Mr. Noah Hunt.
And my brother right here, lead guitar and lead vocals from Shreveport, Louisiana, Kenny Wayne Shepherd.
Recording called The Trap. This next one is called I Want You. Alright, this next song is from a record we put out in 2011 called How I Go. This one is called The Heat of the Sun.
You minutes to the side one more time. Let these boys play the blues.
Wonderful town. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you.